Okay, by now I don't have to tell you that the situation of the symphony orchestras is severe. There's a chance of a loss of employment in the years to come, of not of percentages, but of tens of percentages. Well, you've been told orchestras will be stopped to exist and others will have to merge. And if this threat does not exist yet in your country, it will in the near future. At the moment, in several countries, the immediate cause of the threat is cuts in subsidies. And undoubtedly, the financial crisis is an additional argument, but that does not make the situation less severe. The cuts will be irreversible. For the decades to come, public funding will, however, remain important in the European countries, and orchestras can try to make their products more attractive again for central and local governments, and that may slow down the reduction in subsidies. So you orient yourself still on governments, but hopefully not only. Okay. In the present severe situation, everybody is now not so much looking at governments, but at the possibilities of increasing sponsoring and donations from the private sector. So all, as the Dutch would say, all noses have moved from the government to the private donors and sponsors. And in the short run, this can bring some relief. However, if nothing else changes, the extra funding will be very limited and may easily disappear again. You shouldn't forget that we are not America. We don't have this long tradition of donorship and sponsoring. Well, sponsoring could be become at the same level as in America, but donations, I'm not so sure. It may take a long time and too long for our symphonies to survive. And the main thing is that if the own product is not attractive for large audiences, in due time it will also not be attractive to governments and to donors and sponsors. Yeah, there's a relationship between the attraction to audiences and to sponsors and donors. And sometimes I have a feel that at the moment all this looking at alternative financing is an alibi for not having to look at the own products and the own audiences. And that could be, in the long run, could be very bad. So private funding is not just a matter of private subsidies, but also of funding by audiences, by visitors. So what can bring relief in the long time is more private funding through the sale of tickets, and therefore through the development of products that are attractive for larger audiences and for audiences which are willing to pay higher ticket prices. The fact that at present in a country like the Netherlands the average ticket price of pop concerts is 50% higher than that of classical concerts should be a matter of much concern. People, when I say this, they sort of almost always ignore it because it's too painful, but look at it, it's really something to worry about. And then there's of course the matter of the draying audiences. You can see it all around if you go to the visit various concert halls. And that is, of course, older people have become more outgoing, they spend more money, but it's again, it's only temporary relief. So one needs to convince, and that's also a matter of marketing, that when anno 2011 there are 75 people on the stage serving an audience of often less than 2,000 people, this implies that these people get an extraordinarily rich product, and luxury service. So you have to convince the audiences that this is very special. And also by marketing your product and show them that it's special. Where else nowadays in entertainment you can find these relationships? 75 people on the stage and 2,000 people in the hall. Moreover, it's absolutely necessary to develop new products parallel, note words, parallel to the existing. So I'm not saying that the existing are no good, which will attract new and younger audiences. It's my view that concerts in which there is less ceremony and protocol, in which the atmosphere is more informal and the audience has more freedom to move, and in which there's more personal and intimate contact with the conductor and soloist, will in the long run be the most successful line of additional products, again, additional products. And this intimacy is not a matter of the number of people present in the hall. Even in a stadium, you can notice that with pop concert, there is some intimacy between this huge amount of people and the people on the stage. So it's possible. Finally, it is inevitable to look into costs, production techniques, and the size of orchestras. The production technique of the symphony orchestra is a 19th century technique. In that century, labor was still cheap. But especially after the Second World War, the cost of production of the large orchestras has grown much and much faster than corresponds with the rate of inflation. Up till the 80s, governments were still prepared to cover the additional costs by providing ever higher subsidies. So the cost rises much faster than in the rest of the economy, but up till the 80s, the governments paid for it. But this is no longer the case. So if ticket prices cannot become much higher, this implies that cost will need to be reduced. This can be done by the application of new and unusual techniques. I don't want to go into this too much, but yes, there are many electronic devices now which offer possibilities in this direction. And it can be done by playing more often in smaller formations, for instance with smaller satellite orchestras. You can have these big orchestras, fewer than they are now, but they can operate also with satellite orchestras. And this is a bit painful again, by more flexible contracts. I could think of production houses as we know in Toneel in the Netherlands, where you have, for instance, below the roof, the parapluie of a large orchestra, all sorts of satellite orchestras, ensembles, educational practices, etc. So where many things come together. Presently, it's the accommodations which are developing that. And maybe they're better than orchestras, but in the long run, I think orchestras could do that. Okay, in all these cases, there will be a loss in employment and possibly also a worsening of the legal positions of the musicians in the orchestras, but the loss in employment will be less than in the case of whole orchestras merging and disappearing. Thank you very much.